Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, retired lecturer of meteorology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I render exposition of Luke 7:25 onward. But what went ye out for to see? A man clothed in soft raiment? Not like these temple priests, you know, those chief priests of rabbi. They were clothed in soft raiments, silken and all that. Behold, they which are gorgeously apparelled, dressed, and live delicately, are in king's court. The king's court of they put on nice clothes and other thing, and they live very posh. But what went ye out for to see? A prophet. A prophet means that he is devoted to God, and he had zero dependence on Mammon. Yea, I say unto you, and much more than a prophet, this is he of whom it is written, Behold, I send my messenger before thy face, which shall prepare thy way before thee. He prepared the way before him by baptizing men in water in the name of Abraham, making them sons of men. So the religion is for the sons of men and not for the sons of Satan. A person becomes son of Satan when he becomes a Jew, Sikh, Hindu, Muslim, Fatah, Hamas, of physical body, not of the heart. Religion is of the heart, not of the outwardly or the physical body. So then they were the Jews inwardly, and they were outwardly, they had covenant with Abraham, or they were sons of man, which Christ Jesus called salt of the earth. For I say unto you, among those that are born of women, there is not a greater prophet than John the Baptist. But he that is least in the royal kingdom of God is greater than he. Remember that John the Baptist belonged to the regime of moon. Moon is the reflection of the sun, whereas we in Christ Jesus are sons of God. God is sun, the primary source of light. So we are being the children of light and not of the secondary light of the moon. We are greater than John the Baptist. John the Baptist was a witness to the light because he was a moon and not the light. And all the people that heard him and the publicans justified God being baptized with the baptism of John, which was in the name of Abraham. But the Pharisee and lawyers rejected the counsel of God, because they wanted to make people Jews of the physical body as they are today in Israel, bundled up for final burning, against themselves, being not baptized of him. And remember, John never baptized anyone who did not had a tribal identity. So anybody who said he is a Jew of the physical body, he told him to get lost. And this Lord said, Whereunto then shall I liken the men of this generation? And to what are they like? They are like unto children sitting in the marketplace and calling one to another and saying, We have piped unto you, and ye have not danced. That means, as the normal people are, you know, I gave you a cup of tea, but you did not give me a cup of tea. So a tit-for-tat situation, it is expected of the once-born people. So children are once-born people, and the rabbinic system deals with once-born people. We have mourned to you, and ye have not wept. For John the Baptist came neither eating bread nor drinking wine. So he was simple living, honey and locust, He wasn't drinking wine. And you say he has a devil. So you call that he has a devil in him. The Son of Man is come, eating and drinking, just the opposite of John the Baptist. Because what applies to flesh, the opposite to spirit. So here Christ Jesus says, the Son of Man is come eating and drinking, and ye say, behold, a gluttonous man and a wine bibber, a friend of the publicans and sinners. But wisdom is justified of all her children. So wisdom, the Holy Ghost, justified of all her children. That means you are judged by the wisdom of men and not by just saying whatever you like. And one of the Pharisees desired him that he would eat with him. And he went into the Pharisee's house and sat down to meat. And behold, a woman in the city, which was a sinner. Sinner means she had a leading immoral life. When she knew that Jesus sat at meat in the Pharisee's house, brought an alabaster, a box of ointment, and stood at his feet behind him. That means she could not even wanted to show her face to Christ Jesus. She was so humble, and she stood behind Christ Jesus, weeping, and began to wash his feet with tears. You remember tears, they are the water which comes from your eye. That means she was so shameful of what she had done. She was repentful and did wipe them with the hair of her head. Hair of the head stand are resting on your head are to be very honorable position. So she wiped the feet of Christ Jesus with her honor, which were represented by the hairs of her head, and kissed his feet and anointed them with the ointment. And she anointed them with the ointment that blessed are the feet which came into this house. Now when the Pharisee which had bidden him saw it, he spake within himself, saying, this woman, if he were a prophet, would have known who and what manner of woman this is that toucheth him, for she is a sinner. Now this Pharisee, he invited Christ Jesus not to serve him, but to test him. Not to learn anything, but to just test him like the other Pharisee and Sadducee were doing. So he in himself think, you know, that this, she is a sinner and I'm not, you know. And look what she is doing. And Jesus answering said unto him, Simon, I have somewhat to say unto thee. And he saith, Master, say on. There was a certain creditor which had two debtors. The one owed 500 pence and the other 50. And when they had nothing to pay, he frankly forgave them both. Tell me therefore, which of them will love him most? Simon answered and said, I suppose that he to whom he forgave most. And he said unto him, thou hast rightly judged. And he turned to the woman and said unto Simon, seest thou this woman? I entered into thine house, thou gavest me no water for my feet, but she hath washed my feet with the tears and wiped them with the hair of her head. So I will in the next one I will describe the meaning of this. And God bless you. Thank you very much. hope you are getting.